Welcome back to my channel. I purchased this multimeter from Draz Online Shopping Pakistan from China. Anang SZ303 multimeter, 1999 count. It reached to my home address in 1961 Pakistani rupees, that is equal to $7. Its actual price was 2111 rupees and there was discount, shipping fees and promotion fees. Let's open it. This user manual in Chinese language. And this is operator manual in English language. Different instructions, different features, voltage measurement, current measurement, diode test, frequency measurement, then specifications, characteristics, DC current up to 10 ampere, resolution is 0.1 microampere. And here is in 10 ampere range, 10 milliampere accuracy. DC voltage 0.1 millivolt up to 600 volt. AC voltage same. Resistance 0.1 ohm up to 20 mega ohms. AC current 0.1 microampere to 10 ampere. Diode continuity frequency 0.1 hertz up to 2 megahertz. Then maintenance and general instructions, battery replacement, fuse replacement. Let's check it. Here are test leads. Although these are not very high quality test leads, within $7 range, I think it's good. Then here is universal probe gate. We can make this probe set as per our requirement. In one side we can connect these test probes and second side crocodiles. Same way. We can also make a power cable or interconnect cable. We can make extensions as per our requirement. ₹1.5 AAA size batteries. An ampere socket with this common lead, and here is mentioned maximum 10 ampere. It is current limit. There is fuse 10 ampere for 10 seconds only, and here maximum 600 volt, hertz, volt, milliampere, ohms, diode continuity, microampere, high side common, high side common, select function, hold and backlight. Now in this multimeter, if we need 200 milliampere range, then we will use this socket as a high side, and this is common because here is mentioned 200 milliamperes. For 10 ampere, this socket will be used. AC voltage, volts DC voltage. We will compare these both multimeters. Both multimeter common here, both multimeter positive here. DC voltage, both readings are same. At 19.99, its range will change. So this is DC voltage range. Now we will check millivolt. Millivolt DC, same. It's good. Then frequency. In this manual there is no voltage value. What is the maximum voltage value for frequency measurement? Hundred hertz, 99.7 hertz. Hundred hertz, 1 kilohertz, 1 kilohertz, 998 hertz. There is 3 hertz difference. 1003, 1000. 1 kilohertz. 10 kilohertz. 10 kilohertz. 100 kilohertz. This is not measuring 100 kilohertz, but it is measuring 100 kilohertz, 99.8 kilohertz. 50 kilohertz. 60 kilohertz. The same error. 70 kilohertz. 90 kilohertz. Yes. 100 kilohertz. It is measuring 100 kilohertz, but it is not measuring 100 kilohertz. 200 kilohertz, okay. 500 kilohertz, yes, it's okay. 1 megahertz, 1.5 megahertz. Nice. It is not measuring frequency because it is out of range. megahertz. Good. 2 megahertz. 1.996. 3 megahertz. Yes, it is measuring 2.99 megahertz. 0.9. Minimum frequency 1 hertz. And then up to 3 megahertz it is measuring. Then there is NCV, non-contact voltage. Then here is diode function. Let's check this MOSFET. This multimeter will not test the MOSFETs properly because it is using just only 3 volt battery that is not capable to charge the gate. That is reason it is not turning on the gate. Now if I will use this multimeter, the MOSFET is turned on. It is testing MOSFET because it is using 9 volt battery. If I will check using this multimeter, diode testing properly. Now if I want to charge the gate, it is not turning on the MOSFET because it is using just only 3 volt battery. So this is drawback in this multimeter while testing MOSFETs. then continuity. We will toggle the function using this select function. It provides beep, but its reading is slightly delayed. If you want to test continuity for any cable, one lead here, it is giving beep, but its reading is delayed. Then resistance, test lead error approximately 0.1 ohms. If I will check this 0.24 ohm resistor, it is showing 0.4 ohms. 0.4 minus 0.1, 0.3 ohm, you can say within range. 0.196 ohm resistor is 0.3. 0.3 minus 0.1 error, 0.2 ohms, that's good. 4.7k. resistor, 28.2k, good. There is no temperature function. Current measurement, microampere, milliampere here. When we are measuring current, always use any series load with the battery or any power source, 3 microampere. This test lead is not very heavy duty, common here, and positive lead with any series resistor. ampere, 10 ampere, good. In the same setup, I will use the second multimeter. ampere. Then here is hold function. Anytime we are measuring any voltage, any reading, I will press hold button. Now I will remove test lead. The reading is hold on the display. Pressing again, will it turn back to normal? If I will press long for this button, will turn on the backlight. Long press, the backlight is off. Now if I will turn this multimeter in on position, there is auto power off sign here. It will turn off after a specified time. Auto power off. To disable auto power off, set it to off position. Press select button and then move to any position. Now auto power off is finished. If you use this product, if you are using this product, what is your practical opinion about this? I will invite you to write in the comments. If in this price range, if you recommend some other brand, other multimeter, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.